Yaskawa. You're watching the IEC 61131 Basics Video Tutorial Series. This lesson is on structures. Hi, I'm Matt Pelletier, and in this video I'd like to show you what a structure is and how to create and use a structure in MotionWorks IEC. A structure is an organized set of data with mixed data types. So unlike an array, which has all the same data type, a structure can have any number of different data types. In the end, it ends up to be similar to a file or directory structure with sub-elements. It's a good way to organize your data. And when you use it, you'll end up using complex names with this dot notation. So here in the example that we will do, we have a variable called g_gate1_east. And it has different elements, both Boolean and integer, and it could have other elements as well. And each of those elements are separated by this dot notation. So as in the previous video where we created an array, here we'll create a structure in our data type folder. We go to the data types folder, and we can use this same YTTS custom types. If you don't have this in here, you could right-click to insert a data types worksheet and create YTTS custom types. And then in the edit wizard, you have the struct data type, pull that in. And as we did with the array, we'll just fill in the comments. So I'd like the type name to be called YTTS parking gate. The idea here is we could have one variable that has all of the elements of a parking gate program that we've been using so far. So we don't need to do all of them, but let's do a few of them here. And for example, one important variable that we had been using was, is the gate open or not? And that was always a Boolean. The other important information about a parking gate in our program was the number of cars in the lot. And that number was always an integer. Another one was the max capacity. Another integer. We had a sensor, which is Boolean. And we wanted to know if the lot was open. That was another Boolean. I think I'll take it even one step further and go beyond the minimum. You can also have an array inside of a structure inside of an array, as long as the definition from top to bottom is appropriate. You cannot use an array in one data type that hasn't been defined above it. So since I've defined already this YTTS train array, maybe I'll call this array of data. Can't use the word array by itself. The data type is YTTS train array. Semicolon at the end of all of these. Sometimes I like a quick compile worksheet just to find any real simple errors. Okay, oops, I had a little thing there. Let's try it again. Okay, so the sheet is good. And this little compile worksheet is really all you need now to start using this data type. So in the global variables, like we did when we made our array, let's insert another variable. And this one we'll call g_gate1_east. You know, maybe we've got a parking lot now with a large number of parking gates and all controlled by one PLC. We can set them all up to have the exact same data and keep it a little more organized this way. I'll use the data type YTTS parking gate. And let's do like we did with the array. I will download the changes and then add to the debug. And now in debug mode, I could take a look at this. I'll right click on it and add it to the watch window. Add the whole thing. We can expand it here. And so we can see here, gate to one east. Is the gate open? How many number of cars? So imagine this with five or six different parking gates. Be very easy then to see everything in the same order, same data, same name. Makes it very friendly to work with. You just have to know how to set up this structure ahead of time, which I hope now you know how to do. And of course, you'd have to create your program to use those. So I'll show that real quick here a little bit, at least. So for G sensor, I can use G underscore gate one east. And then here's where we put in the dot notation. And I'll choose sensor. We also had the number of cars. So instead, let's do G gate one east dot number of cars. I typed an N, then down arrow, enter, enter. G gate one east number of cars. We hit a max capacity. G gate one east dot max capacity. I typed an M, down arrow, enter, enter. And so I could go on to update all of this code here. And you can see here to be complete, I probably should have a reset. I should have full in this structure, the timer, maybe this delay time, and lot open would be this one. I'll do lot open here. Gate one east dot lot open. So this is how your code starts to look now with this dot notation. And I'll just be sure this works with one download changes. Okay, close the resource, back to debug. And now I haven't tied this to the I/O yet, so I'll just have to double click on it like we did in the beginning. Oh, I didn't put a capacity in here. There we go, put a capacity in there. All right. And now in this version of the software, 25078, if you want an initial value for any of these elements of the structure, it is required to do that in a structured text POU, or any POU. Usually we'll use structured text. I'll just give you an example of how that would go. If I wanted to initialize maybe with a number of cars here, I could hit F5, put in my G gate one east, and then use the dot notation, and maybe want to initialize that the number of cars here, colon equals. And if you didn't look, if you don't remember what the data type is either, you can, it will tell you here. I didn't point that out. Let me do that again. Number of cars is an int. So number of cars, colon equals, int, pound, and then however many you think it should be by default. I'll do 10, semicolon, and then when will this run? Remember we put init in the cold task and the warm task. So whether we do cold or warm, we will have a reset of this element of the structure using this line of code. And so this is commonly how a structure is initialized, as opposed to putting an initial value in the global list. You can see that there's no way you could put in multiple initial values for a multiple element variable. So thank you. That does it. That's the introduction here on structures. I hope that you know how to make them, a little bit how to use them, and how to initialize them in MotionWorks IEC.